Hello chicos, good morning, sean todos bienvenidos a este nuevo video de nuestra clase de inglés. Siempre es de mucho gusto y mucho agrado encontrarnos por aquí. So, en lo siguiente chicos tenemos nuestra resolución de nuestra clase, which is about text and paragraphs. Pero hoy día nos enfocamos en lo que son paragraphs. Okay. Chicos, en lo siguiente también cabe mencionarles que hoy tenemos práctica en el formulario. Así que estás listo, por favor. So, en lo siguiente tenemos unos párrafos y unos puntos importantes que debemos tomar en consideración y en lo cual voy a ir explicando a medida que avanzamos. Así que, repasar, por favor, y estudiar, chicos. Ok, let's get started, please. Here, paragraphs. Check out the following activity. What is a paragraph? ¿Qué es un párrafo? A paragraph is a group of sentences that combine an idea. Each sentence works together. The word together as part of the journey to create an overall thought or impression. Okay, a paragraph is a small unit or cluster of sentences in which one idea can be developed adequately. Paragraphs can stand alone or function as part of an essay, but each paragraph covers only one main idea. Chicos, acá lo que nos quiere decir que un párrafo es un grupo de oraciones que están de acuerdo con una idea. Cada oración trabaja junto con la parte de la unidad que nosotros estamos creando alrededor de todo el impresionismo. Okay. Or impression. Okay. Un párrafo es un pequeño cluster. Okay. This is as Spanish, I guess. Okay. De oraciones en lo cual una idea puede ser desarrollada adecuadamente. Okay, los párrafos siempre están solos y cumplen una función como parte de un ensayo, pero cada párrafo se convierte en una sola idea principal. Lo que nos quiere decir, chicos, un párrafo es el donde que te menciona. Aparte de tener muchas partes, el párrafo de la primera unidad, cuando se comienza al inicio, nos da muchas ideas. Ahí tiene bastantes partes que nosotros lo vamos a ver en lo siguiente. Okay, en este caso nos estamos enfocando en lo que es el topic. Topic sentence. The most important sentence in your paragraph is the topic sentence, you see, which clearly states in the subject and the whole paragraph. The topic sentence is usually the first sentence of the paragraph because it gives an overview of the sentence to follow. The supporting sentence after the topic sentence helps to develop the main idea. This sentence is a specific detail related to the topic sentence. Okay, topic sentence. A final or concluding sentence after the study summarizes the main idea of the topic sentence. Ok, chicos, nos dice acá. Lo más importante en la oración o en tu párrafo es el topic sentence. Ok, oraciones del tópico, la idea principal. En lo cual nosotros estabilizamos la idea principal de todo el párrafo, como les mencioné. El topic sentence siempre va al inicio de un párrafo porque nos da una idea general de todo lo que va a seguir en nuestro párrafo. Luego viene la supporting sentence, las oraciones de su soporte, okay, seguido del topic sentence. Eso ayuda a tener un estatus a la idea principal. Okay, estas oraciones dan detalles específicos relacionados a topic sentence. Okay. Topic sentence. Okay, chicos, a la final también tenemos el concluding sentence, en lo cual nosotros resaltamos o resumimos la idea principal del topic sentence. Del inicio también se finaliza abajo. A good paragraph has, un buen párrafo tiene. A topic sentence states the main point of the paragraph. Supporting sentence with details and specific examples as proof of your point, logical coherent thoughts that are developed in order from the sentence to be the next to the next, and a concluding idea that wrap up the point of the paragraph. Wrap up significa resumir, chicos. Okay. Read the following paragraph model. Look for a topic sentence, concrete detail, and example of supporting sentence, and see how the writer sums up the point of the paragraph with a concluding sentence. Also, because this is academic writing. Chicos, acá hay que enfocarnos que este ejemplo que lo siguiente vamos a ver es un ensayo académico, okay. Porque esto es un escrito académico. The writer identifies the first line 5. Spaces to mark the beginning of the paragraph. This practice is not always followed in a commercial or instructive writing or in a business letters or memos. Okay, chicos? So let's see, please. Here, read the following paragraph and try to get the topic sentence. Acá nos vamos a enfocar en el topic sentence. My first day of college was a disaster. Oh my god, mi primer día en el colegio fue un desastre. First, I went to the wrong classroom format. I was sitting in the class surrounded by people taking notes and paying attention to how to do equations. Oh my god, which would have been okay if I was supposed to be in algebra's class. In reality, I was supposed to be in a geometry when I was discovered my error. I had already missed the first 20 minutes of 1 hour class. When I got to the core class, all 25 students turned and looked at me as the teacher said, "You're late." Oh my god. That would have been bad enough, but in my next class, my history teacher spoke so fast, I could not follow most of what he said. The only thing I'd hear was that we were having a quiz tomorrow over today's lecture. My day seemed to be going better during botany class. Okay. That is, until we visited the lab, I had sneezing fit because of one of the plants in the lab and had to leave the room. When I finally finished my class for the day, I discovered I had locked my keys in the car and I had to wait for my brother to bring another set. Oh my god. My first day of school was so bad that I know the rest will have to be better. My god, a good story. In the above part, topic sentence appears in a bold and concluding sentence in italics. And notice how the sentence in between support. Chicos, acá nos dice. Tomamos en cuenta que aquí, here, acá en el final nos dice. En la parte de arriba nos fijamos en el topic sentence, en el tópico, y aparece sombreado. Ok, fue acá, chicos. Sorry. Where is it? Here. Este es el topic sentence. Este es el supporting sentence. First, I went to the wrong classroom format. Supporting sentence. Okay, chicos, esto nos da soporte a este tópico de oración. Topic sentence. Ok. Here. Este es, chicos, ya por acá viene el concluding sentence. Que da un soporte acá al topic sentence. Sorry. Al topic sentence. Al topic sentence. Ok, guys. Chicos, más lo vamos a analizar, por favor, en nuestra conferencia de Zoom. Así que estar listos. También, por favor, prepararse para lo que es la práctica en el formulario. Ok, guys. That's it. Really thanks for being here and watching this video. Thank you so much and goodbye.